Hello students, we have learned the first chapter on differentiation. In differentiation, you have learned some examples on differentiation, and differentiability implies continuity, but continuity does not imply the differentiability. And also we have seen hyperbolic function, properties of hyperbolic function, derivative of hyperbolic function, derivative of inverse hyperbolic function. Now we learn successive differentiation or successive derivative. Suppose f is a function, then derivative of f is denoted by f dash. F dash is the derivative of f. Similarly, f double dash is the derivative of f dash. And f triple dash is the derivative of f dash. Means succeeding is the derivative of the preceding. Similarly, nth derivative of function is f raised to n x. So these are the successive derivative of f. If we write y is equal to f of x, then y1, y2, y3 up to the yn are the successive derivatives of y. y2 is the derivative of y1, y1 is the derivative of y, y3 is the derivative of y2, yn is the derivative of yn minus 1. Or y1, y2, y3, yn can be denoted by dy by dx, or d2y by dx square, or here y3 means dqy by dx cube, and so on. Nth derivative of y means d raised to n y by dx raised to n. Or y is equal to f of x means this is the f1, f2, f3 and up to the fn. So these are the nth derivative, first derivative, second derivative, third derivative and nth derivative of y, or y is equal to f of x. Now yn is the nth derivative. Yn at a means value of nth derivative of a, or d raised to n y by dx raised to n at x is equal to a, or f raised to n at a. So this denotes the value of nth derivative at point a. Now we see some examples. Example number 1. If x is equal to a into cos theta plus theta sin theta, and y is equal to a into sin theta minus theta into cos theta, then find d2y by dx square, or find y2. Solution. What is given? You have given, it is given that x is equal to a into cos theta plus theta into sin theta. Now here x is a function of theta, therefore differentiate this with respect to theta. Therefore dx by d theta is equal to a is constant, a into derivative of cos theta, derivative of cos theta is minus sin theta, plus here theta into sin theta, you find the derivative of this by product rule. Therefore sin theta as it is into derivative of theta means 1, then plus theta as it is into derivative of sin theta cos theta, so is equal to minus a into sin theta plus a into sin theta plus a into theta into cos theta, a into theta into cos theta. Therefore minus sin theta plus sin theta, these two terms cancel, so remaining is a into theta into cos theta. Therefore dx by d theta is equal to a into theta into cos theta. Similarly, And again you are given y is equal to a into sin theta minus theta into cos theta. Now you differentiate y with respect to theta, you get therefore dy by d theta is equal to a is constant, derivative of sin theta means cos theta minus, again you apply product rule, cos theta as it is into derivative of theta means 1, then plus theta as it is into derivative of cos theta means minus sin theta. So is equal to a into cos theta minus a into cos theta then here minus a theta again here minus and minus minus become plus a theta into sin theta. Therefore a theta plus a theta minus a theta cancel. So remaining is a theta into sin theta. Therefore dy by d theta is equal to a theta into sin theta. But you have to find d2y by dx square. Now your dx by d theta is a theta into cos theta and dy by theta is a theta into sin theta. But you have to find d2y by dx square. Therefore, dy by dx, this can be written as dy by d theta into d theta by dx by chain rule. Therefore, is equal to dy by d theta is a into theta into sin theta. Dy by d theta is equal to a theta into sin theta into d theta upon dx. You have dx upon d theta means a theta into cos theta. Reciprocal of this means d theta by dx means 1 upon a theta into cos theta. A theta cancel, a theta upon a theta. So is equal to sin theta upon cos theta means tan theta. So dy by dx is equal to tan theta. But you have to find d2y by dx square. Therefore, d2y by dx square is equal to derivative of tan theta with respect to x means sec square theta into derivative of tan theta. So, derivative of tan theta means sec square theta. Now, here derivative of tan theta means sec square theta. But you are differentiating with respect to x. Therefore, sec square theta into derivative of theta with respect to x into d theta by dx is equal to. So, sec square theta into d theta by dx. You know dx by theta is a theta into cos theta. D theta by dx is reciprocal. Therefore, 1 upon a theta into cos theta. 1 upon cos theta means sec theta. So, is equal to 1 upon a theta into sec square theta into sec theta means sec cube theta. 1 upon a theta into sec cube theta. So, this is the y2 or d2y by dx square. So, in this way, you find the second derivative of y. Here you are given x and you are given y is equal to a into sin theta minus theta cos theta. Now, we see the second example. Now, second example, if y is equal to sin of sin x, then prove that डी टू वाई बाई डी एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस टेन एक्स डी वाई बाई डी एक्स प्लस वाई इंटू कॉस स्क्वायर एक्स इज इक्वल टू जीरो. यू आर गिवन वाई इज इक्वल टू साइन ऑफ साइन एक्स. यू फाइंड डी वाई बाई डी एक्स. यू फाइंड डी टू वाई बाई डी एक्स स्क्वायर एंड सब्स्टिट्यूट इन द गिवन डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन एंड यू प्रूव दैट इज इक्वल टू जीरो. और ऑल्सो यू प्रूव दैट by adjustment of second derivative of given function y. It is given that y is equal to sine of sine x. Therefore, differentiate this with respect to x means dy by dx is equal to derivative of sine x means you know that cos x means here cos of sine x into derivative of sine x means cos x. Again you need d2y by dx square and again you differentiate this d2y by dx square is equal to you apply the product rule. So suppose cos x is as first function of cos of sin x as the first function, therefore cos of sin x as first function into derivative of cos x means minus sin x. Minus sin x into cos of sin x plus cos x as the first function derivative of cos of sin x means minus sin of sin x into derivative of sin x means cos x. So this can be written as minus sin x into cos of sin x, then here minus cos square x into sin of sin x. So you have y dy by dx and d2y by dx square. Then you substitute in given differential equation. Therefore, consider d2y by dx square plus tan x into dy by dx plus y into cos square x and you prove that is equal to 0. Means you substitute all values is equal to means I will write here so d2y by dx square means minus sin x into cos of sin x is equal to minus sin x into cos of sin x minus cos square x into sin of sin x then plus tan x into dy by dx. Tan x means sin x upon cos x. Sin x upon cos x into dy by dx is this. Cos x into sin x into cos x means cos x into cos of sin x. Then plus y into cos square x. Y means sine of sine x. Sine of sine x into cos square x. Then is equal to. Now here sine of sine x minus cos square x and here plus sine of sine x into cos square x. These two terms cancel. Here cos x upon cos x cancel, remaining is sine x into cos of sine x plus sine x into cos of sine x and minus sine of x into cos of sine x. So these two terms cancel after cos x upon cos x is 1, then the two terms cancel. So is equal to 0. Therefore, lastly you obtain d2y by dx plus tan x dy by dx plus y into cos square x is equal to 0. So, in this way, you prove the differential equation, given differential equation is equal to 0 when y is equal to sine of sine x. Again, we see one more example. Example number 3. Third example. Show that y is equal to x plus tan x satisfy the differential equation cos square x into d2y by dx square minus 2y plus 2x is equal to 0. You solve same by previous example. So, what is given? It is given that y is equal to x plus tan x. X plus tan x. Therefore, dy by dx is equal to derivative of x with respect to x means 1 plus derivative of tan x means 6 square x. But you need d2y by dx square. So, again differentiating this with respect to x, you get d2y by dx square is equal to derivative of 1 is constant, therefore derivative of constant is 0, therefore derivative of 1 is 0 plus derivative of sec square x means 2 sec x into derivative of sec x means derivative of sec x is sec x into tan x. So, is equal to 2 sec square x into tan x. So, this is the y2r d2y by dx square. Now, you consider the left hand side of given differential equation. LHS of given differential equation is cos square x into d2y by dx square minus 2y plus 2x, and you know that is equal to 0. Therefore, cos square x into d2y by dx square. D2y by dx square means 2 into sec square x into tan x minus 2 into, what is y? Y is x plus tan x plus 2x. So, sec square x means 1 upon cos square x. So, 1 upon cos square x means cos square x upon cos square x means 1. Therefore, is equal to 2 tan x minus 2x this minus 2 tan x plus 2x. Therefore, minus 2 tan x plus 2 tan x. Minus 2 tan x plus 2 tan x cancel. Minus 2x plus 2x cancel. Therefore, is equal to 0. And this is the RHS of given differential equation. Therefore, cos square x into d2y by dx square minus 2y plus 2x is equal to 0. If y is equal to x plus tan x, so this y is equal to x plus tan x satisfy the given differential equation. Hence, lastly, right? Given function y is equal to x plus tan x satisfy the given differential equation. Thank you.